The ESB, for Enterprise Service Bus, plays a role in mediating and facilitating communication among applications that were not originally designed to work together. This includes software from different vendors, independent databases, or business applications, for example. As examples of ESB, we have MuleSoft Anypoint Platform, Red Hat Fuse, IBM Integration Bus, formerly IBM WebSphere Message Broker, and Talend ESB. Beyond communication, through the ESB, applications provide a set of functionalities in the form of services. The ESB then publishes these services in its registry, making them available to applications that request them. An application can both consume and produce services. When multiple services are needed to fulfill a requirement, the ESB orchestrates these services. The ESB also ensures data transformation by adapting message formats and protocols based on the needs, aligning them with the expected format and information level for both calling and called applications. Moreover, the ESB offers intelligent routing, determining the message destination through the analysis of its content and predefined rules. Additionally, the ESB ensures message traceability by guaranteeing message tracking and delivery. It also manages communication errors between applications by implementing error handling mechanisms and incident recovery. Furthermore, the ESB serves as a message manager, enabling asynchronous message communication, also known as message-oriented middleware. This means the exchange of messages between two applications that are not active simultaneously. This is made possible through a queue that receives the message from the sending application and stores it until the receiving application is active and reads the message. It is through these functionalities that the ESB fulfills its role in integrating data within the system. The ESB automates data exchanges between different components of a system by imposing a standard for inter-application exchange. This significantly saves developers time, since they only need to develop standard communication means for their applications, such as HTTP or HTTPS communication. The ESB takes care of anything specific through the use of connectors provided by vendors. And finally, I will explain the difference between ESB and API Gateway, because there is often confusion between the two. While both facilitate communication across systems, both address different use cases. API gateways simplify the process of exposing APIs to external consumers. It gives the client a consistent interface regardless of any changes within the internal system. This means the system can evolve without causing problems for the clients. ESBs organize different ways services communicate. In this way, services don't have to talk directly to each other, making things less complicated. It's worth noting that companies that make API gateways and ESBs are working to bring these two things closer together. They're adding features from each side into their products. Nowadays, many companies offer both as one combined product or as two parts that work well together. Thanks a bunch for tuning in. I hope you found it both educational and entertaining. To stay in the loop with all things tech and computer science, be sure to click that subscribe button and ring that notification bell. I can't wait to share more insights with you in my next videos. Goodbye.